In this episode of Mighty Car Mods, we continue unmodifying and transforming our sex-spec show car. Welcome to another episode of Mighty Car Mods, proudly supported by Just Car Insurance, where the evolution of Too Sexy continues.
That's right. So last time you saw the car, we were stripping all the excess out of it.
The XX?
The XX show car.
Yep, the X-sexiness.
Out of it, and now it's on to like fun things like test fitting wheels and figuring out suspension and... Yeah.
And doing all the good stuff. Mm. And Too Sexy is actually in the rear right now.
It is in the rear.
Back there is all of the stuff from Too Sexy that is no longer required. And we're on the way to the tip.
That's right, which means we should be able to get a weight both before and after to find out how much it weighs.
And just see how much sexiness is being offloaded and thrown in the tip. Now you may be wondering what happened to our ute? Because we used to have a ute until recently, and that's a bit of a long story. Now we've got this mad Ford Transit Custom, which Ford actually lent to us, probably because they felt sorry for us after they saw Marty lose the Too Sexy battle. But this is our car to use on the show, so that we can tow stuff to the track,
which is carry things around. Way better for putting stuff in. Firstly, you don't have to tie it down like you do with an open tray ute. And yep. Secondly, it's got like a 2.5-ton towing capacity, which means we can put our cars on trailers.
Which is mad. And the other awesome thing is when we're going to meet, we can actually take all of our mad stuff and things in there without having to worry that it's going to get stolen out of the back. Like that time somebody stole that t-shirt of yours, Martin, and then later posted photos of themselves wrapped in it half nude on the net. But we try not to think about that too much.
I don't like to think about that guy too much.
So anyway, we're on the way to the tip now, and Too Sexy is about to get thrown in a pit and crushed. Are you okay about that?
No, I feel great. You know why?
Oh, you feel great.
We're throwing out all the useless stuff.
Yep.
And keeping all the awesome.
Okay,
turbo,
good.
Turbo, little like lightweight turbo racy car looking thing. I'd be mad.
Yeah. I'm going to say, Martin, this is cathartic. This is like it's therapy, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because it's like you get all of the stuff that you don't like and you put it in a bubble of the tip and you let it float off into the garbage.
Yeah, and look, it was a thing. Like, I'm not denying that once upon a time that was very cool. When it was brand new, someone put a lot of effort in, all that kind of stuff.
I agree with that.
You know, and it was a thing, but look, time was not kind to it.
Yeah.
And and now we're gonna refresh it, we're gonna give a new lease on life, and it's gonna be even more mad.
Yeah, except I think it's probably worth saying, all the things that somebody else loved, the less of those things it has, the more you're gonna like it.
Pretty much.
We are on the way to the tip, and it's time to say farewell to the remnants of Too Sexy. Morning. Hello.
Hello.
We've got a sex-spec car from the early 2000s that did the show car scene during Autosalon. It's garbage.
Oh, okay. Yeah, sorry, so you can say something else.
You guys alright?
Having a fit.
A laughing fit.
A laughing fit.
What did she think we had in here?
That was just general rubbish, eh?
General rubbish.
That's probably the best way of describing it. Yeah.
So,
it's a car that's designed in like the sex spec style, and it was probably around like 15 years ago. It was at Autosalon, dropping pants, and now we've pulled it apart, and it's in the back. And we're gonna throw it in your bin. Thank you.
That's fine, thanks.
General waste.
Bye.
Thank you.
From the bright lights of the show car circuit to the dump, and Marty must be getting pretty emotional.
How are you feeling, Martin?
Fantastic, actually.
Really?
Bye-bye.
There's no sadness?
None at all.
Really?
Getting rid of all the crap, keeping the best bits, man. Bye-bye.
So on the way in here, we were 2.32 tons.
2.32. Cool. Wonder how much it cost to throw out all your showcar stuff.
We're about to find out, aren't we, Martin? Hello again.
Hi.
$63.
Tap and go?
Yeah, tap and go, thank you.
What was our difference?
Shut up.
I think she's been affected by the two sexiness, dude.
How much sexiness did we just throw out, approximately?
160 kilos.
That's two of me.
Amazing. Thank you.
Thank
Have a good
you.
Day.
Too sexy.
160 kilos.
Not bad. What did I say? 200? 300?
You said 300. I said 200. We're both wrong. We sucked. Let's we not suck. Quit our day jobs.
But 150 kilos, man.
Yeah.
That's significant in a car that weighs, you know, whatever
That's
it weighs.
That's a huge difference. Huge like difference.
10% something?
I don't know. Martin, let's hit up the wreckers.
All right.
And see what we can get.
So we are down at the wreckers attempting to get some bits for Too Sexy.
How much better is that? Oh, what is in that?
That's pretty good. Do you like that?
No, I don't.
CE Lancer, my friend.
Oh, really? Original. A bit grot. No, I'll pass. Need new gear stick.
So buying that one then? Thank you, mate. All good.
With some of the parts collected for our much needed makeover, it's time to head back to the shed.
Rear tail lights that bring us out of the sex-spec era and into track car.
It looks so much better.
Beautiful softness.
Looks so much better. And we got this.
Yeah, which is also white, which is cool. So it's the same color, which will look good. And a front bar. Our front parts are really hard to find for these cars because people keep stacking them all the time. This one's just got a tiny little mark there, but we're going to have to cut this out to fit our mad front mount.
Let's go and lay it on, Martin, so that we can actually see what it looks like. Yeah, it's going to need some customization to
it's
fit out.
It's going to look all like it's going to look smaller, but that's kind of cool. You know, it's just going to sit on there and chop that out neatly, and so the front mount just sits in there. Get rid of this number plate thing because we don't need that anymore.
No, it's better.
You can do all sorts of cool stuff, you know, like get air onto your brakes easier if you chop that out and do some fiddling. So I'm pretty excited about that.
Now, Marty, we want to try and get some kind of venti bonnet, don't we? Because there's extra turbo heatness coming
out
of there.
There's a lot of heat generated by that, and also if we're going to lean on the motor more and try and make it faster, it is going to get hot. And I don't really like big vented bonnets on street cars, really, but I think for a car that's going to be on the track and that kind of stuff, I think getting heat out of the bonnet is definitely not a bad thing. And being that you can't buy stock bonnets for these cheaply because everyone smashes them, it's actually going to be more cost effective to buy an aftermarket one that's got probably got vents in it and all that kind of
stuff.
And
it is a matter of being function over form as well.
Oh, totally.
Because track car.
I don't really care what it looks like so much because it'll just look like a race car. We need some inside bits too. I don't really want to chop myself up on the inside, so I'm going to put like just a crash pad on there and some console bits and door trim so that you're not scratching your arms and things when you're driving.
And Marty, these actually look really good. If we can kind of demo them up, let's just do a quick little, let's do a before. Yep, and now let's do an after. Oh, it's so much better.
It is. And they're proper to good quality wheels. Now they can probably get lighter race car wheels, but we are on a bit of a budget, and
that's all money, Martin.
Yeah, they're good. I mean, they're not heavy really for how big they are. The tires will fit perfectly. They're a good size. They're going to fit. They're not going to rub on anything.
Yeah.
And we can readdress wheels later down the track. But I'm really happy with them for the price. They're in really good condition too, and I think the color's cool. So
it's going to look good, man.
It's going to look good, and then we've got to stick some suspension in it as well. So that's like later down the track too.
So many awesome things to do, Martin. So but for now, I suggest we get our mad RE003s, we get our mad rims, we chuck them in the transit, we go combine their forces, plus get all our tools that we've laid out here and head down and hack up some cars at the wreckers. Because in Sydney, there's an awesome place where you can actually pull the cars apart yourself.
Oh, do you remember when we found the poo?
Yes, I do.
In the Mazda?
Man, that still haunts me to this day.
That was a long time ago. I wonder if the poo's still there.
Wow. If not, we can probably generate one.
We are heading out to the western suburbs of Sydney to pick our own parts for Too Sexy. Because you have to pull the parts off yourself, it ends up being much cheaper than going to a traditional wrecker, and it's a lot more fun. Now the first step is to hunt out all the crashed Lancers, Evos, that still have some useful parts left that we're going to need for our Too Sexy make under.
So one of the things on our list to get is a bonnet, because we threw our other one in the bin.
Yeah, I got really sick of looking at it with the red gauges on it. I had to get rid of it.
Well, earlier today we were talking about, we can keep making excuses, but we actually just threw our bonnet out.
Yeah.
And now we're going to buy another one.
Yeah.
Is the reality of what's going on, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it's fine.
We were going to get an aftermarket bonnet all like Benty. That was like literally our plan not
this
that long ago.
This isn't a Lotus, man.
But like, they're really like expensive.
Yeah.
And like carbon fiber ones and stuff. So now the plan is just to buy another bonnet to replace the one we only just threw out an hour or two ago.
Yeah.
And we didn't like that one because it had gauges and holes in it. But this one will possibly end up without like cutting holes in it anyway.
May do. We'll see.
For better heat dispersion.
But at least it's like a nice, straight, normal one.
That's true. For our track car.
Yeah. We've got to get wiper blades too, because my current one's a bright white.
I just called it our Martin.
Did you?
That's I crossed cute, the line.
You're coming across, aren't you?
Oh my God. Oh, I've been really excited pulling these Lancers apart.
Yeah.
I am feeling it.
They're so easy to work on, man. Again, it wins that challenge.
Put my hands up, pull my pants down. Martin, see what this thing, this exhibit?
Yeah.
Apparently it's called a bonnet stay.
Better than a bit of wood, for sure.
You still get wood anyway though, right?
Hey.
Hi, Martin.
So many bits. We have so many bits. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm pumped about our Lancer. Your Lancer.
I'll let you drive it.
Can you find super cheap in Blacktown for me? I think it's on Richmond Road or Richmond Street.
Sure.
With the whole interior of Too Sexy now crushed into a festering pile alongside used condoms, eggplant and garden gnomes, which were all potentially used at the same time, we now need to grab ourselves a mad new seat so that we can hit up some hectic G-forces when we finally get Too Sexy ready for the racetrack.
Dude, you know what's awesome about this? This is the fulfillment of a prophecy, because these are the ones we were meant to buy for my Saab, remember?
Can we get a bit of, we're gonna give it a white text string.
Yeah, a Saab to it. And dude, look how cheap they are. $245. Barjane.
Not exactly a race seat, but it'll do the job.
Dude, of course it's a race seat. It's got race stitching on it.
Taking a seat. Do you get it?
That's really bad, man.
Taking a seat.
That's terrible. We're double banging, Martin.
You've got all sorts of cloud technology, including the C2 system, which gives you voice control for hands-free fire.
Did you like being lost in the wilderness with me, Martin?
I mean, yeah, often I've, yeah, how many times I've been marlin fishing since then?
How many times?
Zero.
Okay, we have got our mad seat and now it's time for the journey to continue.
As usual with these kinds of things, we've almost burned a whole day on just picking up stuff.
Yep.
It takes a long time, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's a lot of driving around. Sydney's like, it's kind of big. It's kind of a big place. And if you're going from, you know, one side to the other and then back again, and you know, all the places you've got to go, wreckers and things. We're lucky with this car though that it's so common that like parts are just everywhere.
Well yeah, there's Lancers everywhere you go, there's Lancers.
Could you imagine trying to do what we just did with a Saab?
Or a Mini?
Or a GTR or something, like you just couldn't.
Yeah,
you just couldn't. So I mean that's...
And also not for the price, like every single thing that we bought today was $349 that we pulled off those cars.
Yeah.
$349.
It's pretty cool. Because outside, inside, little bits and pieces, all the screws and associated stuff that goes with it.
Yeah.
Which is hard, can be hard to find. Yeah, it's cool.
So next up, we're gonna get our tires put on our rims.
Yeah.
So we're on our way now to do that. What's up? Mad tires,
going on the mad rims.
Yep.
For our mad Lancer. I mean, your mad Lancer.
You love it. You love it. You're slowly getting seduced by Too Sexy.
Well, because you're the only one here that has a track car, Martin, and I want to use it.
Man, I've never had a track car before.
I know. What are you going to do with it?
I don't know. I'm going to thrash it. That's what you do, isn't it? Till it breaks, and then you fix it and go again because race car.
We are back at the shed with another van load of crap for our Too Sexy race car. We've got a stock bonnet, plus our stock bumper, stock interior parts, dash, rear lights, and all of the other random bits and pieces that we picked up this morning that are ready to go on the car.
And now it is time, Martin, to assemble all of this turd onto the rolling turd.
This is like Lego. This is literally Lego car. All the bits are laid out. We've got our instruction manual, which is inside our brain holes. And we're gonna make all this fit in there. And I reckon, do you reckon we should get rid of stickers?
Yeah, all the stickers will go.
Stickers gotta go. Change our tail lights, change our bumper bar, boot, interior plastics, and I'm really looking forward to putting our wheels on.
They're gonna be awesome. I'm looking forward to the seat. Did we get the right tail lights? See how these have got that angle? Because apparently there's three different kinds of Lancer tail lights, Martin, and we've found out because we're learning.
The tail lights.
And some of them are like, see this angle down here?
Yeah.
Some of them are like straight. Other ones that we got though. Sorry, we lucked out.
Yeah, they're gonna fit.
Those are the right ones.
More importantly, they fit the boots. I think you can put different lights on, but you've got to get the matching boot. Because there's ones that have the cutout, the big cutout here, or there's ones that have the thing straight across the back, which are different. But this is gonna match, so we're all right.
Martin, we're learning about Lancers.
We're learning about Lancers.
Who would have ever thought started as a joke is now providing us education and entertainment.
And that really fun bit of working on a car where minimal tools, minimal parts, it's all cheap stuff. You can just go and have a go, it's mad. I reckon we start piecing stuff together so we make sure our parts fit, like put our bumper and our boot and our bonnet on so it's back to looking like a car.
Good idea.
Interior we'll play with a bit, although I want to fix up some of the wiring first.
Yeah.
And then we will go through, hopefully we'll get our wheels at some point today.
Yeah.
And also then we can look at doing the dashboard inside and then we can put our bucket seat in.
That's awesome. Cool, man. All right, well maybe, let's do bumpers first.
Yep.
Should we do that?
Yep.
Let's do bumper, then do boot, because that's going to be easy.
Yep.
Then, actually, the front bumper's going to be a bit of work, isn't it? Because we've got to do some cutting.
The bonnet will go on easy, though.
Let's do the easy stuff then. Let's do rear bumper, boot, bonnet, and then we'll get the Dremel and start hacking the front bar to fit on that front mount.
What is that, do you reckon?
I reckon that was attached. Do you know what that is? I reckon that was attached to the aftermarket rear bar, and that was designed to suck up slaz.
Wow.
Do you know what I mean? Like you meant to slaz that up so that instead of the bar you're sitting
mesh
on.
Mesh inserts in those, you know, massive fiberglass bumper bars or something.
Yeah. All right, let's do it, Martin.
So sometimes when you've got these old bumper bars with old brackets that don't want to stay connected, these don't have a lot of load on them, but they help locate the bumper. So what you can do is drill a little hole in them and then jam a cable tie through, and you can loop it back or not, whatever you want to do, and that is usually enough to keep that on. And if it gets a big enough hit, it's just going to pop the cable tie or break that little bit of plastic. But it beats going to have to buy all this new stuff, and it also saves you having to fill it full of slaz, which is what we saw on the old bumper. But we're going to do it a little bit neater. So that will now keep that bumper bar on the side of the car, and all it took was some cable ties and drill bit. Done.
Our next job is to get rid of these truly vomit-inducing aftermarket taillights and replace them with the much classier and much more race-ready factory lights.
It's not a beautiful looking tail light, but it's better, isn't it?
Perfect fit. So much better, isn't it? Who would have thought?
That's awesome, look at that. Oh, love it. From that, to that. So much better.
Does it look heaps better?
It looks so much better.
Oh wow, Someone paid money for that.
Yeah.
Wow.
Are you going to try and sell these?
No. The guy at the wrecker said they're not worth anything.
So when we were pulling this bumper bar off the wreck at the wreckers, a bunch of these plastic clips, they break because they do get brittle and old, especially when they're left in the sun. But you can buy kits of these, which I bought these. It said they were for a Nissan, and then when it arrived, it says Ford F1. So I assume it's for an F1 car made by Ford. But it's a whole bunch of these plastic clips. They're just kind of cheap and nasty, but they'll do the job, and then we'll hold this stuff back on, meaning you don't have to use cable ties, because in this situation, the cable tie is not going to work. But one of these things, literally jam it through the hole, press it real hard, and bang, it's attached.
Now we can continue piecing together all of the parts. With the rear back together, now we can get to work on the front. With the bonnet on, now we can move on to what's probably going to be the most challenging stock part to fit, and that is the front bumper, because we've got to somehow get it around this massive front-mounted intercooler.
So there was probably some good reason as to why that big, festy bumper was on here. It's possible that that's the only bumper you could buy. I'm trying to be polite. I'm trying to suggest the only reason that bumper was on the car was to fit this like huge intercooler.
I reckon the intercooler was made to fit the bumper bar.
Really?
Do you remember how many cars with Autosalon when they didn't have turbos but they had big front mounts?
Yeah.
That was a thing.
It was a thing.
So I reckon, I mean, this will fit. All this bulgy stuff has to go. Yeah, that can go. We've cut out all this bolt and we just do a line down here. We'll just sort of chop that out. Look a little bit hacked, it'll be all right.
We can try and hack this bit out, but I reckon if that doesn't work, we just go full wasabi style and just cut this into thirds, throw away the middle and slap on each side. You don't want to do that, do you?
We are resorting to the air hacksaw to get this bumper to fit.
Had great success with our front bumper bar. No stock bar was ever going to fit over this cooler, so we have had to modify it extensively with an air hacksaw, which is extremely satisfying. I highly recommend it to anyone. But this would be hard to do to a car that you liked.
Yeah, even just taking this off each time and throwing it on the ground like we just don't care, it's getting all scratched up and stuff.
Yeah, and we need to use cable ties to attach it because
quality cup.
The reinforcement bar is not going to fit. This doesn't have a standard reinforcement bar on it anyway, so we're just going to cable tie it on, because essentially it is just a cover at the moment. That's all it's really doing.
Yep.
So we're going to cable tie it on front and back, 88 style.
Because race car.
I was speaking to Turbo Yoda the other day, and he said to me, well, I actually said to him, I go, man, what do you think of Too Sexy after all that? And he's a man of, you know, few words, who just said, front mount's too big. And you know what?
It probably is too big.
You know, sometimes people say stuff like that and you're like, oh yeah, but why? And but, you know, thermal efficiency and flow. And I just went, okay.
Yeah.
I believe
it. It's funny, you know, a lot of people, particularly on the internet, when they're talking about like, you know, when we're working on the Forester and they're like, you can't get that power with the standard top mount intercooler. You can.
Yeah.
You actually can. And having a chat with the mechanical Stig, and the other dudes down at Itchy Barnes, like, it's amazing what power you can get through stock parts.
Those guys,
including stock
11s.
Airboxes.
They're running 11s on those things with air-to-air intercoolers.
It's crazy.
Pretty cool, man. Starting to be a thing.
Short version is, though, when Turbo Yoda talks, you listen.
Yeah, if he's talking about turbos, that's for sure. Don't get him started on his pet iguana collection. That's just...
Oh my gosh.
I just don't want to know.
Little Guido, he's cute, isn't he?
He's a cute iguana.
So we wanted to try and keep the bottom of this bumper because we just wanted to. But Marty's side over there is on. My side over here.
It's not happening.
That's...
Yeah, it's not happening. The front mouse is too massive.
That's as close as it's going to get.
Yeah.
So...
Being that these bumpers are, what, $25?
We're going to chop it.
Yeah, I reckon we chop it.
If it's disastrous, we'll just go buy another one.
I'm so happy with that. I love it. I love it.
All right, Martin.
Mm-hmm.
Are the external modifications complete?
Well, there's nothing else that needs to be stuck on it.
Is there some like factory side skirt available?
I think you can get factory side skirt, and I think they look pretty cool, just little subtle ones, and it might also cover up the grot that's on there.
Yeah.
So I might try and get some, but I don't know.
Yeah, let's do that. Until then.
This is amazing.
You're pretty happy?
I'm loving it, more and more. There's a milk crate as a seat, which is an issue, and there's also some terrible wheels still on it.
Yeah.
So I want to go and get our mad wheels.
Yeah.
We've got our 003s put on, and I want to put them on.
Awesome. So seats, wheels, some more body kit bits, maybe.
Interior.
Plus a few other surprises.
And an interior.
Next time on Mighty Car Mods.